हेलो फ्रेंड्स, हाउ आर यू डूइंग? माय नेम इज अतनु दे, आई वेलकम टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल B2M, बिगिनर टू मैस्ट्रो। इन दिस पर्टिकुलर वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस रिगार्डिंग एक्सेप्शन हैंडलिंग एंड लिस्ट कॉम्प्रिहेंशन। व्हेन समथिंग इनअप्रोप्रिएट हैपन इन प्रोग्राम देन वी गेट एरर मैसेज, दैट इज कॉल्ड एक्सेप्शन। रनटाइम एक्सेप्शन हैपन फॉर मेनी रीजन्स सच एज वेरिएबल नॉट डिफाइंड, डिवाइड बाई जीरो वैल्यू, शो ऑन एंड सो फोर्थ। दिस एक्सेप्शन कैन बी हैंडल्ड यूजिंग ट्राई स्टेटमेंट। फॉर एग्जाम्पल, ट्राई within the try block, if you want to print a variable called a, now you have to write except block, that is exception handling block. Print, you can print a message like error occur. For this code, output will be printed error occurred, because the a variable is not defined in your code, but you are trying to print it. If something inappropriate happen outside of the try block, then it will stop your program and throw the error message. If something inappropriate happen within the try block, then it will not stop your program, it will pass it to the exception block. For example, in this case, so here something inappropriate happened because this a variable is not defined in your code, and it is pass it to the exception block, and it will print error occurred. This statement will be executed and it will be printed as the output of your code. You can write more than one exception block using appropriate name of the exception or error. For this example, A is not defined. So the error name is name error. So that's why with the except block, we have to pass the error name. Then only it will come directly to this block instead of coming this except block. For this example, if you would like to change the print value, instead of a, if you would like to write 5 divided by 0, then it will not come to this exception block, because here it is name error and it is divided by 0 error. So instead of coming to the defined exception box, it will come to the exception box which is not defined by any name. So that's why it will come directly to here and it will print the statement that something else happened. You can use else keyword to define a block of code to be executed if there is no error occurred in the try block. For this example, there is no error occurred in the try block because we are printing something within the quotation. That means this is a string, this is not a variable, so there is no error occurred. So output will be, first B2M will be printed within the try block, then there is no exception, that will not go to the exception block, directly come to the else part because there is no error happened. So then it will print this part also, that's nothing wrong. So these two will be the output of this code. Finally block is a block which will be executed regardless of try block raise an error or not. In the previous example, we have seen that else block will be executed if there is no error occurred in the try block. For this code, output will be something wrong, because as you have seen in the first example, the variable a is not defined in your code outside of the try block. Now after executing this exception block, it will come to the finally block at the end. So now total output will be something wrong, and then I am in finally. At the end, you can raise an exception by your own using raise keyword. For example, x equal to 0 you are defining, and if x less than 1, then you can raise an exception. This raise is a keyword as well as exception is also a keyword. So you can pass your own message, that is called, like you can pass the message like error. Okay, so now when this code will be executed, so here it is 0, so now condition will be passed, it will come here, it will raise an exception, so it will throw the exception and exception message will be error. List comprehension means reducing list creation time using some syntactical construct which is available in some programming language such as Python. For example, I want to separate each letter of the word and I want to store each letter in a list. So we can take example of a word like my name Atanu, right? And each letter of the word I want to store in the list. So now, so here empty list, I'll create outside of the for loop. Now I'll create a for loop. So here L in, I can pass that string here. So now here within the letter list, I will append each letter. So output of this, if you print the letters here, then output will be A T A N U. Each letter of the string is separated and stored in a list. This is a traditional way to create a list. Now we'll see the same example using list comprehension. For example, we have already the string my name Atanu, right? So now here letters is a list, within the square bracket pass L for L in pass the string. So now each letter of the string is coming to this L, and this L passing to the letter to this L, this L is storing to this list letters. So now if you want to print letters, so then output will become same as the previous output A T A N U. This is called list comprehension. List comprehension is faster than the normal for loop, because it is optimized for the Python interpreter, which can spot a predictable pattern during looping.